Aaron asked about key management and lifecycle. That one's kind of tough because I actually knew people that had like RSA keys and they just kind of like drug them along with them from place to place to place until they stopped working because the default configuration for SSH didn't work anymore with them. But that's something that you can set in the SSHD config.
Leave that.
Yeah. If somebody is using something super old, you can just disable it and then they can't use something super old because you don't allow that to be one of your authentication methods anymore.
Right.
So
yeah, what I do is I take whatever the current standard is for an SSH key and I go up a couple levels and that's what I make my SSH key. And that way it lasts forever.
Now, is that it, Nate?
Yeah, right. I'm going to have to find a quantum secure SSH key algorithm and make my new key with that.
On post-quantum cryptography. Yeah, so I mean, as long as their keys that are in place are 10 years old, as long as they are an adequate encryption cipher, that's fine. I think the bigger thing is if you start changing it, you'll find out really quick that somebody has it and it doesn't work anymore, and then they'll start yelling. But that's an easily changed SSHD config thing. So you could issue new keys and get them copied wherever they need to be and test them out, and then go into SSHD config and remove the older cipher.
Mm-hmm.
And if somebody's using it, you will find out very quickly.
Yeah. And if it's not necessarily a cipher you're trying to protect against, the only other thing that rotating keys really protects against is a lost key, right? So if my laptop was stolen, or if I had my key on a thumb drive so that I could plug it into another machine, or if I used it on another machine and forgot to delete it, right? That's the sort of thing that forced rotation of keys can help protect against, you know, if you don't know that your key is in the wild. However, setting a password on that key is exactly what that's supposed to help protect. If I left my key somewhere and there's a good password on it, it makes it a lot harder for someone to take and use without my knowledge.
Yeah. And I think the SSH parlance is passphrase.
Phrase.
Because essentially that's a key or a piece of data that you type in that will then unencrypt the encrypted key to then present half where you're going.
Right. And that's all local. That's not an exchange of a password up to the server. That's between you and your key.
Yeah, right. And so that actually ends up storing your key encrypted, which is why it prompts you for the passphrase so that it can be unencrypted to then be presented as a credential when you're going somewhere. And so that's just kind of keeping it encrypted at rest if you have a passphrase set on your key.